Hey everyone, my name is James Bailey. I'm the head of business development at Subcrew. And today I have Kevin, a developer relations engineer at Moonbeam, joining me today for a quick conversation about Moonbeam and of what we're doing together with the Gitcoin Hackathon.
Hey James, thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, and that, can we kick this off, Kevin, maybe just for a very short introduction about what Moonbeam is, if people haven't heard of Moonbeam, which is going to be surprising at this stage. Those that haven't, quick introduction.
So Moonbeam is an Ethereum-compatible smart contract platform on Polkadot. We want to be the gateway to the Polkadot ecosystem, and our goal is to provide the most seamless development experience for Ethereum developers to deploy their applications, you know, to the Polkadot ecosystem.
And that's really important, right? Like you provide that seamless introduction or that bridge over to the Moonbeam world, right? You can bring your existing Solidity smart contracts, your existing code, all your applications that work today, and bring them into the new world where there's a lot better performance, a lot lower fees, and all the other benefits that come with it.
And Polkadot unlocks really, you know, a world of new opportunities, on-chain governance, forkless upgrades, and much, much more. So we're really excited about it.
Yeah, it's a really compelling proposition, and you can kind of see why there are must be thousands by now of projects working on Moonbeam, right? It's one of the hottest networks in Polkadot. And congratulations on winning your slot in the auctions. I'm looking forward to when Moonbeam starts up. And I think it's like the 15th or 16th of December, right?
So the 17th of December, we'll start producing blocks. And then our full launch will happen in January. The full launch will be when transfers are enabled and the full EVM is launched.
That's going to be exciting. So today we're going to have a quick conversation, I guess, about, Subcrew, Moonbeam and Astar are jointly sponsoring a grant in the latest Gitcoin hackathons, their 12th rounds of grants this December, and it's just kicked off. But I thought it'd be great to talk to you, Kevin, about, what the problems, where that grant stems from, I guess, what's like the story behind that grant and why is it a problem, right?
Absolutely. So with Moonbeam, we have kind of the substrate side, and we have the EVM. Our primary focus is the EVM. But there are certain native functions such as staking and governance, which are not always accessible from an EVM-based blockchain explorer. So there are some components that are built in you can access, from a substrate-based explorer. However, generally speaking, there's not one main blockchain explorer where you can pull in both. And for a new user, this is like a very important issue because they might go to one explorer and they might say, hey, my transaction's missing, or it might just be a difficult first experience, right? And so the goal is that we want to have a unified blockchain explorer powered by Subcrew that enables this. And that's why this challenge is so exciting.
Yeah, it's interesting. You've made it so easy for people to bring their smart contracts over, to bring their applications over. But there still is like a two world, right? There's like within the EVM and outside of the EVM and a little kind of overlap between the two. And partly because, yeah, I guess at the moment you go to Subscan to see what's happening on the substrate side. And then you quickly jump over to talks like, is it Moonscan, to see what's happening within the EVM side.
Yeah, Moonscan is our primary EVM explorer. And, you know, once you're kind of in that environment, you might never leave it. You might be perfectly happy just staying in Moonscan and using the EVM explorer. But if you're doing other functions like staking, or you have crowd loan rewards that you want to look at, then it might be useful for you to also use, Subscan.
But this is that core proposition of really what Moonbeam's about, right? Bridging these worlds, making it easier to kind of to move into this new Polkadot world and take advantage of that. So I can see why this is important. The grant, by the way, is here. It's jointly sponsored. It's got a huge amount of 12,000 USDC that we're sponsoring for this. And one of the best things that we've done actually is provide heaps of examples. So we kind of go into the problem as we've talked about here, but there's a huge opportunity. And there's one of the best things about Subcrew and about the way that we've built it is that we have plenty of running examples. One of them being this example, right? We've written this example. And I think Scott was on the Moonbuilders workshop not so long ago, and we should link, we'll link that as well to this. Scott was on that Moon Builders workshop, providing examples of how to build this live. But there is a running example showing data from within and outside of the EVM on subqueries hosted service. And there's also the code. You can go right into the code and fork this and start working off it, right? It's very straightforward, as well as documentation that we have. So, Kevin, what do you think the winning or one of the winning propositions or solutions is going to look like? What do you think is going to make a good submission in your view?
I think the first and foremost, the winning team, you know, is going to have a strong focus on the user. So they're going to be power users of Moonbeam. They're going to know, you know, be familiar with both, you know, the EVM and with Substrate. And just kind of know like what the problems are, right? So hopefully they could try like to make some trades or experiment with NFTs or yield farming and the like, so that they know like what people are looking for when they come to this type of explorer.
And like we're talking before about, you know, there's some certain pieces or certain like activities that are common where they cross, and then they're the main pain points. Like, I guess, you know, like transfers that originate from Substrate to and going over to, you know, the EVM. I would like to think that the solution kind of handles these kind of really tricky cases very gracefully. And as you say, it is written for an advanced user, but it should also be easy enough to understand so that we can, like, by using it, you can learn about how it works and you can, people can become advanced users just by learning it, I guess, is what I'm trying to point out.
Absolutely. Yeah. And one example in particular is that the using Moonscan right now, if you're staking Moonbeam tokens, they just get sent to one specific address that ends in like 008. And so it's not clear what it is. It's just, and your balance actually, you know, decreases by the amount. So it's unclear to a user, you know, they're staked, but now they left my wallet. And, you know, are these still my tokens? Yeah.
All the people on the EVM side are thinking, wow, this whale address has got heaps of funds. Why is everyone paying to it? Like the tax man. Yeah, no, that's a good point. And then, you know, being able to map these flows and see that, no, that's you're staking your tokens. So that'd be excellent. Yeah. And I'm really looking forward to a really simple user interface. And one of the best things about, you know, using subquery, but also the Polkadot ecosystem is designed to be interoperable. It's designed to work with other chains. And one thing that is built for Moonbeam here and Astar as well, but could also apply to many other parachains that will be building their own Ethereum virtual machine over time. That's a very common use case across Polkadot to invite developers in by supporting Ethereum virtual machine. Obviously Moonbeam have done it the best, but it's a common use case that is replicated a lot. So that's one of the best things, is that this application should be quite transferable to other blockchains or other parachains in the Polkadot ecosystem.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, Kevin, I thank you very much for joining today.
Thank you so much for having me, James. I just want to say that we're so thrilled to be partners with Subquery, and your focus on decentralization, your focus on making it easy and fast, you know, for developers to grow their applications and access this critical data is just unparalleled. And we're so thrilled to be able to work with you.
But we share that with Moonbeam, right? Like, I think, you know, as you say, Moonbeam, your aim is make it easy for Solidity developers to come over to the new world. And even though we're making it easy for developers index data, it's still the same aims here are to make it easier for people to participate in this world, to work together to become more decentralized over time, and to accelerate the transition to a Web3 kind of environment. And that's a mission and a drive that I think both Moonbeam and Subquery share.
Indeed. Indeed, we do.
Thank you very much, Kevin. And I look forward to working with you to look at all the results and all the submissions. We're going to have a good time going through all those.
Can't wait. Thank you so much, James.